let's discuss about property value. In other words, the sniff test of property. Of course, when you're buying property, most people go down the route of getting reports. And these reports can either be bought or provided by the professionals. My suggestion is to have a very strong hard look at these reports. And the reason being that most of the time, these reports are backward looking, not forward looking. In other words, they're looking at data that is historical to determine or predict or forward project valuations and performances in the future. Of course, it doesn't take into account what's really happening on the ground. In other words, what infrastructure is going in right now. Usually these reports are done from a collection of data that is usually a couple of months old and therefore has not taken into account infrastructure that has already started. As an example, it could be that there are multiple developments happening in that street, which the report has not highlighted. It could also be that there have been a lot of off-the-plan sales that are about to settle that will then certainly skew the data in that area, or have just settled and therefore has skewed the data in the area. So you need to be on the ground to actually truly determine the value of the property. The other way you could look at it is also in terms of comparisons. So what are you comparing the property with? Are you comparing a 3-bedroom pristine property against a 4-bedroom property in a slightly better area? The true way to compare it is to be able to compare within walking distance to the property, preferably the same street, if not within half a kilometer to 1 kilometer radius of that property, as to properties that are for sale, properties that have sold, and equally importantly, properties that are up for rent. Because if there are a myriad of properties up for rent around you, you need to then ask that extra question as to why that is the case. Perhaps it's the norm for that area, because that is a large transient population in terms of tenancy, or it could be that the area is going through a downturn in terms of its demographics or in terms of crime, and therefore there is a lot more tenants that are exiting out of that area. So ground research, ground truth is very, very important in determining the value of the property that you're buying, along with the reports that come with it. The final thing that you need to look at with this property is how it sits in your portfolio. What value does it bring to your portfolio? And equally importantly, does it diminish the value in your portfolio? In other words, by adding this property to your portfolio, does it make the portfolio a little bit more top heavy? Or does it make it less liquid and therefore a lot more cumbersome to change if you needed to? So you need to look at the problems it presents, whether the problems can be solved, and compare that with, say, a property in the area with the problems already solved. So what I mean by that is perhaps the clutter in the property. Get rid of the clutter, and how does it compare? How does it sit in a portfolio in terms of cash flow, in terms of strategy, and it also, more important, in terms of exit strategy? How can we get out of this property? Once you've addressed all of that, that'll help you determine what the value of the property is to you.
Thanks so much for watching. For more great insights, head over to our website, rightpropertygroup.com.au. You can also tune into our podcast, Investing Insights, or follow us on all socials. We look forward to seeing you again soon.